Now let us discuss operations of integers. So operations of integers means the addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So we have already completed the addition and subtraction in earlier classes. Now we will revise once again the operations such as addition and subtraction, then we will go for the multiplication and division. So on the operations of integers, so first we will take addition. Addition of integers. Now when you add two positive integers such as 5 plus 3 equals to we get 8, then 5 plus 2 equals to 7, then 5 plus 1 equals to 6, 5 plus 0 equals to 5, then when you decrease the number which is being added by 1, so the number being added decreased by 1, then the value of the sum also goes down by 1. Now 5 plus of again when you decrease 0 by 1, then we get minus 1. So this equals to when you decrease 5 by 1, then the result will go down to 4. Then 5 plus of minus 2 equals to, so here also the number being added is decreased by 1. So then even the value of the sum also decreased by 1. Then we get 3, and 5 plus of minus 3 equals to 2, and 5 plus of minus 4 equals to 1. Now when the number being added is decreased by 1, then the value of the sum also decreased by 1. Now let us see the same addition of integers. So up to 5 plus 1 equals to 6, the two positive integers are added, and here 5 plus 0, a positive integer is added to 0, and from minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, then a positive integer is added to the negative integer. Then you will see the same addition case on the number line. So on the number line middle we will take 0, then right side to 0. So we take all positive integers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and left side to 0 we take negative integers such as minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6 and so on. Now let us take the integer 5 plus 2 equals to 7. So when you take 5, so first 0 to 5, so from 5 then adding 2, so 5 plus 2, 1, 2, so this is 5 plus 2 equals to 7. So when you add a positive integer, then we move right on the number line. And if you take a positive integer and a negative integer, then 5 plus of minus 2. First 0 to 5, then minus 2. So what is the result of when minus 2 is added to 5? The result is 3. So then to reach 3, then we should move left. So 1, 2. So this is minus 2. So when you add a negative integer, then we move left on the number line. So when you add a positive integer, then we move right on the number line. And when you add a negative integer, then we move left on the number line. So then we get 5 plus of minus 2 equals to 3. So we can write the property that each time you add a positive integer. You move right. On the number line, then each time you add a negative integer, you move left. And the number line. So when you add a positive integer, then we move right on the number line, and when you add a negative integer, so we can move left on the number line. We should move left on the number line. Then if two integers are added, then what is the sum? Is the sum greater than each of the two integers? For example, when 5 plus 2 equals to 7, in this case the sum 7 is greater than each of the two integers 5 and 2. But is it always true? Is it always true for any two integers? Now let us see. 5 plus or minus 3 equals to 2. Here 5 and minus 3 are any two integers. Their sum is 2. But here 2 is less than 5 and 2 is less than, and 2 is greater than minus 3. But we can say that when two integers are added, the sum is not always greater than the two integers. It may be greater than any integer, or it may be less than the two integers. So in this case, 5 plus or minus 4 equals to 1. So when 5 and minus 4 are added, then the sum is 1. So here 1 is less than 5, but 1 is greater than minus 4. Now let us represent the following additions on the number line. So represent the following additions on the number line. Now the first question, first addition is 4 plus 3. Now how to represent the addition 4 plus 3 on the number line? So as we have discussed just before, so first let us draw the number line, and on the number line we will take 0, then left side to 0 we take negative integers as minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, and right side to 0 we take positive integers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Now 4 plus 3. So first we take from 0 to 4. So this is 4. And here plus 3 means positive integer is added. So when we add a positive integer, then we move right on the number line by 3 units. So 1, 2, 3. So this is plus 3. So then 4 plus 3 equals to, so we reach 7. So then we can say that 4 plus 3 equals to 7. Then how to represent the addition 6 plus of minus 3 on the number line? Here a negative integer is added to an integer. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Then on the left side to 0 we take minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, and so on. Now first 6 means from 0 to 6. So then when you add the negative integer, we move left on the number line, so that is minus 3. So then from 6 we move 3 units left, so 1, 2, 3. So this is minus 3. So then 6 plus of, again we reach here 3. So then we can write that 6 plus of minus 3 equals to 3. So when you add a positive integer, then we move right on the number line, and when you add a negative integer, then we move left on the number line. Now let us solve the next question. Compute the following. So yeah, the two positive integers are added. So when you add 7 and 4, then we get 7 plus 4 equals to 11. So then here, second question, 14 plus of minus 6. So then 14 plus of minus 6. Here 14 minus 6 is 8. So here a negative integer is added to the integer 14. Now 4 plus of minus 4. So 4 plus of minus 4 equals to 0. And 13 plus of minus 15 equals to. Now 15 minus 13 is 2. And the bigger number 15 has minus, so we write minus 2. Then 100 plus of minus 80. So 100 plus of minus 80 equals to 100 minus 80 is 20. 225 plus of minus 145 equals to. So when you subtract 225, when you subtract 145 from 225, we get 5 minus 5 0 and carry 10. 10 plus 2, 12 minus 4, 8, 1 minus 4, 0. So then we get 80. And here, bigger number 225 has plus sign. So the result is plus 80. Now let us see the subtraction of integers. Now if you observe the subtraction of integers from 5, so 5 minus 3 equals to 2, and then 5 minus 2 equals to 3, then 5 minus 1 equals to 4, then 5 minus 0 equals to 5. So the number being subtracted is decreased by 1. If you see the pattern in all these subtractions, the number being subtracted is decreased by 1, then the value of the difference is increased by 1. So your 2 plus 3, 1, 2 plus 1, 3, then again 3 plus 1, 4, and again 4 plus 1 is 5. So then 5 minus of minus 1 equals to, then 5 should be increased by 1, so then we get plus 1 equals to 6. Then 5 minus of minus 2 equals 2. So again 6 is increased by 1, then we get 7. So 5 minus of minus 3 equals 2. 7 is increased by 1, then we get 8. So here also, if you see the pattern, the number being subtracted is decreased by 1, then the value of the difference is increased by 1. So from right side to 0, we take positive integers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and so on. And left side to 0, we take negative integers minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, and so on. Now when you take the subtraction case, 5 minus 2 equals to 3. So first we take 0 to 5. And here, a positive number is subtracted. So when you subtract the positive integer, then we move left on the number line. So then we 1, 2. So this is minus 2. So then we got the result such as that is 5 minus 2 equals to 3. And when you subtract the negative integer, so if you take 5 minus of minus 3 case, that is 8. Now when you take 5 minus of minus 3, the result is 8. So first we take 0 to 5 units, then minus 3 to reach 8. So again we move right on the number line, 1 2 3. So this is plus 3, then 5 minus of minus 3 equals to 8. So when you subtract a positive integer on the number line, we move left, and when you subtract a negative integer on the number line, we move right. So we write this statement. So each time you subtract a positive integer you move left on the number line. Now each time you subtract a negative integer, you move right on the number line. So when you subtract a positive integer, we move left on the number line, and when you subtract a negative integer, we move right on the number line. Now let us represent the following subtractions on the number line. So represent following subtractions on the number line. So first question is 5 minus of minus 4, and the second question is minus 4 minus of minus 3. And first let us draw the number line. Zero. So right side to the zero. 1, 2. Positive integers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And left side to zero, we take negative integers -1, -2, -3, -4, -5, -6, -7, and so on. So first we take five minus of minus four. So let us represent 5 on the number line, 0 to 5. And when you subtract negative integer, then we move right on the number line. So we move more 4 units on the number line. So then we get 1, 2, 3, 4. So then we reach 9. So therefore, 5 plus of 5 minus of minus 4 equals to 9. So minus of minus is nothing but plus. So 5 plus 4 equals to 9. And when you subtract negative integer, again here we move right on the number line. So first let us represent minus 4. So 0 to minus 4. So this is minus 4. So here also we are subtracting negative integer on the number line. So when you subtract negative integer, then we move right. So here we move 3 units right. So that is 1, 2, 3. So we reach minus 1. So then minus 4 minus of minus 3 equals to minus 1. So this can be written as minus 4 minus of minus become plus 3 equals to minus 1. Now let us solve the following subtractions. The first question, 17 minus of minus 14. So this 17, so minus of minus becomes plus 14. So this equals to 17 plus 14 is 31. and 15 minus 28. So let us subtract 15 from 28 first, then 28 minus 15 is 13, and bigger number 28 has minus sign, so we write minus 13. The next question, 25 minus 33. Now this equals to, let us subtract 25 from 33. So 33 minus 25 is 8, and the bigger number 33 has minus sign, so we write minus 8. Then 80 minus of minus becomes plus 50. So 80 plus 50 is 130. The next question, 150 minus 75 equals to 75. Now 32 minus of minus 18 becomes plus 18. So 32 plus 18 is 50. Now let us see the multiplication of integers. Now let us multiply the two positive integers. So 4 into 3. So 4 times 3 means 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3. So this equals to 3 plus 3 is 6, 6 plus 3 9, 9 plus 3 12. So the multiplication means it is nothing but the repeated addition. Now when you see this on the number line, minus 1, minus 2, left to 0, then right, we take positive integers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and so on. So then here 4 into 3 means 4 times 3. So we should take 4 jumps each of 3 steps from 0 towards right. So first let us take 1, 2, 3. So this is, so then first jump of 3 steps, then again second jump of 3 steps we will take now 1, 2, 3. So this is second jump of 3 steps, then again 1, 2, 3. So this is third jump of 3 steps. So this is 3, 3, 3. Again the next fourth jump of 3 steps. 1, 2, 3. So this is also 3. So 4 into 3 equals to 12. There are 4 jumps of 3 steps each time. So then we get 4 threes are 12. Now when you multiply two positive integers, the product is also a positive integer. Now let us multiply a positive integer by a negative integer. Now let us see the case 4 into minus 3. So here 4 into minus 3 means here minus 3 is added 4 times. So minus 3 plus of minus 3 plus of minus 3 plus of minus 3. Then let us see what is the result. So again you will draw the number line. Zero, one, two. Then we take negative integers left side to 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9, minus 10, minus 11, minus 12, minus 13, minus 14, minus 15, minus 16, minus 17, minus 18, minus 19, and so on. Now 4 into minus 3 means here minus 3 is added 4 times. So we will take 4 jumps of 3 steps each from 0 towards left. So 1, 2, 3, so this is minus 3. So this is first jump again. So again we will take minus 3, 1, 2, 3, this is minus 3. So this is second jump. So 1, 2, 3. So this is third jump, again minus 3. So 1, 2, 3. So this is also minus 3. So we reach minus 12. So when minus 3 is added 4 times, then we got the result minus 12. When you multiply a positive integer by a negative integer, so we got the product as the negative integer. Now let us see the other examples. So when you multiply 5 and 4, a positive integer by another positive integer, so we get 5 plus 5 times 4. So 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4. 5 fours are added, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 fours are 20. And when you 3 into minus 6. So yeah, 3 times minus 6. So then we get minus 6 plus minus 6 plus minus 6. Here minus 6, minus 6, minus 12, minus 12, minus 6, minus 18. So here also when you multiply a positive integer by a negative integer, we got the product again as the negative integer. So even you can take 4 into minus 5. So then we get minus 5 plus of minus 5 plus of minus 5 plus of minus 5. This equals to minus 20. So here also the product of a positive integer and a negative integer is a negative integer.